German arms manufacturer Rheinmetall will deliver a new Frankenstein air defense tank to Ukraine. The Frankenstein air defense tank consists of an advanced German Skyranger anti-aircraft gun mounted on a Leopard 1 battle tank. Bjorn Bernhard, the head of land systems at Rheinmetall, said in an interview with the German tabloid Bild, "There are still many Leopard 1 main battle tanks on whose chassis we could mount the Skyranger turret with the 35mm caliber automatic cannon." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Frankenstein air defense tank could help Ukraine defend its skies. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Russia has been deploying drones to take out Ukrainian targets. One weapon has been particularly troublesome for Ukraine. The Iranian Shahed 136 drones that Russia has rebranded as Juran are packed with explosives that are pre-programmed to loiter overhead until they nosedive into a target. It's powered by a 50 horsepower engine with a top speed of 185 kilometers per hour or 114 miles per hour and has a maximum range of 2,500 kilometers or 1,500 miles. The drone is thought to have a 40 kilogram or 88 pound explosive charge. Shahed is cheap, only $20,000 a piece. It's only a tiny fraction of the cost of a more conventional full-sized missile. For example, caliber cruise missiles that have seen widespread use cost about $1 million each. It's tiny. Radar and IR signatures are small, making it hard to detect, and when used in large numbers, like a swarm, some of these will surely go through and create havoc. Also, the continuous buzzing of the propeller-driven Shahed drones, dubbed mopeds by Ukrainians, induces anxiety and has a psychological impact. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky noted the terror element, posting on social media, "The whole night and the whole morning, the enemy terrorizes the civilian population." After the Cold War, most Western land forces eliminated their mobile air defense systems, creating a vulnerability that became evident with the resurgence of air threats in the early 20th century, such as during the Second Nagorno-Karabakh War. To counter this issue, Rheinmetall Air Defense developed the Skyranger 30 concept demonstrator, which was publicly unveiled in March of 2021. Its role is to provide ground units with a mobile system capable of engaging fixed and rotary wing aircraft, Group 1 and 2 unmanned aerial systems, UAS, loitering munitions, and cruise missiles. In December 2023, the Skyranger 30A1 development testbed was validated in live fire exercises at the Ocean-Boden Proving Ground in stationary and mobile modes. The Skyranger 30 follows the same general configuration as the Skyranger 35, a remote turret with a 1.414 meter diameter turret ring, but with less weight of 2 to 2.5 tons, enabling it to be installed on lighter 6x6 wheeled vehicles. The system is designed to both be operated autonomously and in networked operations. It's fitted with a modified version of the Orlikon KCA 30mm cannon used on the Saab 37 Viggen fighter jet named the KCE. While it has a shorter effective range than the Skyranger 35 at 3 kilometers or 1.86 miles, it has a higher rate of fire of 1,200 rounds per minute. It maintains the ability to elevate 85 degrees to combat terminal diving targets. 252 ready rounds are carried. The gun fires a 30mm airburst munition based on the 35mm ahead ammunition, carrying 160 tungsten cylinders, each weighing 1.25 grams, for a total payload of 200 grams, which is time-programmed upon leaving the muzzle to open up in front of a target to form a lethal cone. To detect targets, the Skyranger 30 uses the S-band AESA multi-mission radar AMMR developed by Rheinmetall Italia. Five flat antennas integrated around the turret provide full 360-degree coverage. The AMMR has a detection range of over 20 kilometers or 12.5 miles for a 1-square-meter RCS aircraft, 12 kilometers or 7.5 miles against hovering helicopters, 10 kilometers or 6.3 miles against missiles, and 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles against RAM targets and micro UAS. A Ku-band tracking radar is available as an option. For passive detection, it's installed with Rheinmetall's FIRST, that's Fast Infrared Search and Track, which is optimized to detect pop-up targets such as helicopters. Identification and tracking are handled by a compact target tracker that includes one HD cooled MWIR thermal camera, one full HD TV camera, and two laser rangefinders, one devoted to air targets and the other for land targets. The turret features a central armored structure with basic level 2 protection, which can be fitted with add-on armor to increase to level 4. Additional features include two ROSI rapid obscuring system launchers, each with 9 multispectral smoke grenades, a hatch in the hull ceiling for the vehicle commander to view the battlefield from outside, and a coaxial machine gun fitted on the left of the main gun for use as a self-defense weapon. Kyiv has been urging its partners to send additional air defense systems as Russia intensifies its strikes against Ukrainian population centers and infrastructure. Germany is answering its call. Apart from the Frankenstein air defense tank, it will also deliver its third Patriot system to Kyiv in the coming days, as confirmed by Chancellor Olaf Scholz. Ukraine's Strategic Industries Minister Alexander Kamishin said as of January, 5 projects have been developed under the Franken-SAM concept, with all the systems already deployed on the battlefield. Frankenstein air defense tank will be effective against a wide range of targets, which makes it a very versatile weapon. Secondly, it will be much cheaper than many other options like Stinger Manpad, which costs up to $20,000 each. Thirdly, the mobility will enable it to be used in different locations as required. It remains unclear when Ukraine will get this platform. The earlier, the better.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.